So, guys, I'm going to show you something really funny. I bought some flowers. I'm here in a beautiful park in Florida, and I want to show you how to do amazing focus stacking photos of trees. So we have the flowers here as a foreground element. I have my tripod very low with a 12-24, which is a very wide lens, and I'm going to take the photo of this tree with his flowers in the foreground. And it's going to be a really cool effect. So stay until the end, because I'm going to show you how to make it even more dramatic. I have a special secret of retouching coming at the end of this video. It's going to be crazy. All right, so I'm at 100 ISO f11. I'm actually going to boost the ISO a little bit because I don't want to go under 150. Why? Because there's a bit of wind and I want to make sure it's super sharp, super sharp. This is a Sony mirrorless camera. And what I love about it is you can have touch operation on, make sure it's on. Usually it's the bin. If you press the bin, the touch operation goes off, and if you press it back, it's on. And when it's on, you can just put your finger over something and make sure it's sharp. So I'm going to take a photo. Yeah, there's really wind, so you want it sharp. And then I'm going to put my finger here, like on a flower that's a little higher, and I'm just going to take another photo. And then I'm going to put my finger on the tree here, and I'm going to take another photo. And then I'm going to show you on a different tree. So now we're on a different tree, and same things, I position the flowers. So now I'm like 320 ISO because there's a bit of wind. I really want to make sure I'm at 150. Very important for the speed. So one photo, boom. Then I'm going to click on a flower that's just a little above. It's really cool because we have the sun setting right there, which is amazing. And I go a little up and another one on that tree. And voila. Back from this shoot, and I've imported the photo into Lightroom. So I basically have four photos, but you see they're pretty much dark. It's hard to tell which one is in focus on what. The reason they're so dark is I was shooting straight on the sunset and I really wanted to have the dynamic range. So I exposed for the highlights, but because the Sony 7 R4 is so powerful, if I open up the shadows, maybe boost the whites a little bit, and bring down the highlights, you know, I'm just doing it like a really basic retouching, and then I'm syncing that with, I'm selecting all photos, and I'm going to sync that correction, check all on all the photos. I can really quickly see if I'm sharp at the right place. If I'm going a little fast, this is my latest book on Lightroom, Lightroom Classic Natural Drama. You can get this book for free if you just pay the shipping. The link is under the video. So anyway, here I am. And photo number one, you can see I focused on the flower. This one is a little bit of blurry because there is a minimum distance with the 12-24 and that was too close. But this one is pretty sharp. This one is pretty sharp. But you can see the tree is very blurry. Okay. Then if we go on the second photo, this one is starting to be a little bit blurry and I'm really focusing on these flowers here. And then the third photo, the tree starts to be in focus, but you see the branch here is still very out of focus. Okay, and in number four photo, now the tree is extremely in focus, and the flowers is completely out of focus. So I'm good. I know I've made my shot successful. So now I'm going to do my basic retouching. So what do we do in retouching? Well, I want to do a lot of retouching first in Lightroom, then go to Photoshop. I want to make it this dramatic and beautiful. So first photo, I already, you know, did, I'm going to check my black point. So for that, I'm just going to hold on the option key and boom, make sure you get about like, so the black point is just pixels which are 100% black. There's no more detail. So I'm just, I usually want about 1 or 2%. That's kind of cool. And then I'm going to boost the contrast. Now on this one, I want to use a very cool profile like landscape. So I'm going to go to profile and I'm going to go to camera matching because these are Sony files. And I'm going to use the deep profile or the landscape. I'm going to use a landscape profile. Yeah, you see the landscape profile really makes the color pop. So I'm going to close that. Now the photo is a little dark, so I'm going to boost the overall exposure like that. And I want to add maybe a bit of more magenta to the sky. I brought down the highlights. Let's see. Maybe we can make that sky a little darker. So I'm going to go here. Let's try this. Select sky. So it's selected just the sky and let's make it a bit darker and maybe a little bit bluer and a little bit more magenta in the sky, something like that. Don't go overboard. It's going to look weird. Just a little bit goes a long way.
Okay, that's good. It's the new, you know, it's the new sky selection. Then I want to make the flower pop a little bit more because they're the star of the photo. So I'm going to take a brush. And when you take a brush, make sure flowing density is in the 80s. The reason is if you put it at 100 and you add a bit of exposure, when you brush, you're going to really see the brush stroke. You don't want that. So Command Z to undo. Let's do it again. That's why when I use a brush and I do dodge and burn, I put the flow in the density like in the 70s or the 80s. I was born in 1970, a very good year. Anyways, so and then I'm just going to brush inside of that flower, maybe add a bit of exposure. And then maybe add a bit of like, let's add a little bit of like texture and clarity on the flower. Because the whole idea is to have like this very sharp flower, you know, and don't brush everywhere, just in some parts. And again, what we're doing on one photo, we're going to put it on all the photos. Okay, I like that. I think I want to make the horizon a little more straight. So let's see if we go down here to remove chromatic aberration and enable profile correction. Look at the horizon here. And boom, it's a little bit better. It's a little bit better. Not quite there yet, but also it's very blurry in the back. And you will see as we focus on the back, it gets better. You can always change like aspect ratio. But yeah, on this one, I'm not going to do it. I kind of like that. Let's add some like postcard veneering a little bit to focus a little bit inside of the photo. I want to make the sunset pop a little more. So I'm going to go here. And I'm going to add a big radial circle where the sunset is. It was a nice sunset. So I'm just going to add some more yellow and some more magenta and some more saturation so that it pops out. Let's make a big sunset. That's kind of the star of the photo. Yes. Now we're talking. Okay, cool. So, you know, it's a shame that everything else is blurry, but now that we've retouched this one, I think I'm good. I think I kind of like what I did. On the overall photo, I'm maybe going to use a little bit of minus clarity. I think it gives like a more, less HDR look to it. And then I'm going to select all four photos. I'm going to click on synchronize. I'm going to call check all, make sure that all the mask that I've done here, all the local adjustment, all the dodge and burn is selected and synchronize. And wait for it. Now, it's going to take a few seconds because I'm using AI. For example, the sky has been replaced with AI. So now all the photos have the same retouching, which is crazy, you know, and look at that. And on the back, oh, it's beautiful. Okay, so now I'm going to select all the four photos and here comes the magic. We're going to make this one photo into one sharp photos. So right click, edit, open as layers in Photoshop. Very important, open as layers Photoshop. The reason why you want this is because you want to have one Photoshop file and all the layers inside of the Photoshop file. So here I am in Photoshop and all I have is the layer panel open. You can go to Windows and make sure that the layer is open. We don't really need anything else but layers. So I got the layer open. I've got my photo here. So the first thing we need to do is you hold on the shift key and you select all the layers, okay? Once you have all the layers, you go to edit, and you go to auto align layers because, you know, and click on okay. Just use the default settings and you're going to, oh, okay. The reason is, you know, when I was touching the screen, as you saw on the camera, maybe I slightly moved the photo. And if I did, it won't be able to blend the focus perfectly. So you first always, always, even if you shot on a tripod, you align the layers. Okay, now everything is aligned and you just, it's still selected here. So you just go to edit and now you go to the magic. Blend layers, same thing, you just use the default option and that's going to make one photo to rule them all. And boom, look at that. Look at all this masking that's been automatically. And let's inspect our photo. I'm going to click on any of the layers. I'm going to take the zoom tool, Z for zoom tool, and let's inspect. So this one we know was a little bit blurry from the start, but look, it's sharp here, it's sharp here, it's sharp everywhere. And this is kind of phenomenal, that kind of photography when you have that, because people are not used to see that. So now I'm ready to just go to File, Close All, and then I'm going to save it. And that's going to bring it back to my Lightroom. Boom, it's back here. Look at this photo. It's incredible. Everything is sharp from the start to the end. I love it. I'm going to do a double dodge and burn because I want to sort of darken some parts. So I'm going to lower the exposure, make sure flow and density. I use the middle mouse to make my mouse go bigger, and I want to darken this a little bit. I want to focus the eyes, not so much here. So, you know, there's a trick in photography. It's called dodge and burn. You darken what you don't want people to look at, and you brighten what you want people to look at. So I want people to look at the flower and the sunset, and that's why I'm making everything else dark. And voila. So I do have to recrop a little bit the photo slightly because the alignment did something weird to it a little bit. But, you know, maybe let me try if I can make this one 16 by 9. I'm not sure it's going to work. Oh, maybe it is. Nah, it's cutting too much of the tree. So I'm just going to do a classic 4x3. And then let's make it big. Yeah, I want to get the whole... Yeah, I want to get the whole thing here. A little bit on the side. Yeah, I just... There's a bit of a white line here. And voila. And voila. Look at that. Everything is kind of sharp. Almost everything, except this was too close to the line. But from here all the way to infinity, everything is sharp. It's beautiful. Try it. You know, it was so funny bringing in the flowers. Like, it's kind of like I faked it with the flower. But, you know, it's kind of making a photo instead of taking a photo. Don't forget, you can get my book for free. Just pay the shipping and you'll get it. You're going to love it. If this is a 5-step way to use Lightroom. I have simplified Lightroom so much for you guys. Check it out. And I have an amazing video for you. It's called 10 Lightroom Hacks that you should try. The video is starting right now. You can click on it and watch it. It's going to take your knowledge of Lightroom to a whole new level.